Good morning, dear students. In previous class, we have solved exercise 1.2. In this class, we are going to talk about the multiplication of integer. Multiplication of integer. As you know, multiplication of integers, we know that multiplication of whole numbers, is repeated addition. Okay, first point I am taking here in multiplication of integers. First point, multiplication of positive integer and a negative integer. When we multiply one positive integers with a negative integers, we will get again negative answer. See, we multiply them. If we will take two numbers, one is the positive number, one is the negative number, where we multiply them as whole numbers and we want to put a minus sign before the product, we get the negative integers. See, I am taking here one positive number, one is the negative integers. See here, this is the positive integers. I am taking here one is negative integers. When we multiply these two integers, we are getting here 4 into 2 is 8. See here, plus into minus minus. See, we want to put the negative sign before the answer. So, we will call a into minus b. If we will change the order of the integers, again we will get the same answer. So, see here, if I am changing here, minus a into b. So, answer is, if you multiply in any order, if you multiply one positive integer and a negative integer in any order, we will get the same answer. So, we will call multiplication of a positive integers and a negative integers, we will get the negative answer, negative integer. Dear friend, see, I am taking the next one, multiplication of a positive integers and a negative integers. See, when multiplying positive integers with a negative integers, we will get here negative integer answer. Okay, if you changing order of integers, you will get the same answer. See here, 4 into minus 2 is equal to, answer is minus 8. See, when you getting the answer, you put the negative sign before the answer. If you changing these two integers, if you changing order of these two integers, you will getting the same answer. See here, a into minus b is equal to minus a. I am changing here order of integers into b is equal to minus a into b. You are getting the same answer. If you changing the order of integers, you are getting the same answer. Dear friend, next I am taking here multiplication of two negative integers. See, I am taking here multiplication of two negative integers. Multiplication of two negative integers. Two negative integers. See, if we multiply two negative integer, okay, in the answer we will get in here positive integers. Okay, if we can say that the product of two negative integers is a positive integer, we multiply the two negative integers as a whole numbers and we put the positive sign before the product, before the answer. See, one example. See, I am taking here two negative integers. First one is minus 2 and I am multiplying with minus 3. This is also negative integers. This is also negative integers. When we multiply these two negative integers in the answer, we are getting here positive integer. Okay? We are getting here positive integer. See here, minus into minus plus 3 into 2 is 6, minus into minus plus. So I am getting here positive integers. See that a minus a into minus b is equal a into b. Okay, understood? See, when we multiply two negative integers, we'll getting as a positive integer as an answer. We want to put the positive sign before the product. Okay, dear friend, next I am taking here product of three or more negative integers. Okay, see here, I am taking here the next point. Product of 3 or 4 negative integers. See, if you multiply 2 negative integers, we are getting here positive integer as an answer. Okay, see, if we multiply the 3 or more negative integers, 3 or 4 or more, see here, more negative integers. If we multiply 3 or more negative integers, we have to take here, see here, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So, these numbers, I am taking here, odd numbers, here, I took here 3 negative numbers, negative integers, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. These are the odd number. Okay, when we multiply these odd number, we are getting again minus 1. Okay, if you multiply even number, if you multiply 4, 2, 6, 8, like this, even number, if you multiply even integers, we will get in product as a positive integers. Okay, understood? Product of 3 or more negative integers in a product is even. Okay, then the product is a positive integer. If the number of negative integer is a product is odd number, then the product is a negative integer. Okay, see, one example, minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. These are the odd number. When we multiply these numbers, we are getting here negative number. If we multiply even number, see, I am taking here 4 minus 1. When we multiply even number, we get in here positive integer, that is the 1. See here, minus into minus, plus, plus into minus, minus, minus into minus, plus. Again, we got in here 1 as a positive integer. Okay, understood? Multiplication of 3 or more negative integer. If we have odd number, we get in the negative integer. If we have even number, we will get in the positive integers. Okay, next, dear student, I am taking here properties of multiplication of integer. Dear student, I am taking here next point, properties of multiplication of an integer. First point, closure and multiplication. Dear student, when we multiply two integers, we will get in the same integer. Well, when we multiply two integers, again we will getting the integer. See, so we can say that when we multiply, the product of two integers is again an integer. So we can say that integers are closed under multiplication. Dear friend, I am taking here an example. See here, example. See, I am taking minus 2 into minus 5. when we mean multiplying these two integers, we are getting again integers. So a into b is an integers for all integers a and b. See here, we are getting here answer also integers. When we multiply two integers, again we are getting integers. Okay, next I am taking here the next point, commutativity under multiplication. See, when we multiply two integers, if you change the order of integers, you are getting the same answer. Okay, see, so that multiplication is commutative for whole numbers. First example I am taking here. See here, example one, I am taking here 3 into minus 4. When we multiply this 3 with minus 4, we are getting here plus into minus minus 3 into 4 is 12 answer. When we changing the order of integers, so I am getting here minus 4 into 3. If you multiply again these numbers, we are getting the same answer. See here, plus minus into plus minus 4 into 3 is 12. Okay, these, if you changing the order of integers, you will be getting the same answer. So 3 into minus 4 equal minus 3 into 3. See, we got here equal answer. The above example suggests multiplication is commutative for integer. For any two integers a and b, is a into b is equal b into a. Okay, dear friend, I am taking the next point, multiplication of zero. Multiplication by zero. Multiplication by zero. Any whole number, when we multiply it by zero, that answer also zero. See, any whole number, when multiplied by zero, answer also gives zero. Example, see here, example, minus 3 into 0. Example, when we multiply whole number with the 0, we are getting again 0. Another example, 2 into 0. 2 into 0 is 0. See, when we multiply with 0, when we multiply any integer with 0, product also 0. This shows that the product of a negative integers and a 0 is always 0. See, for any integer a, that is a into 0 equal to 0 into a. But dear friend, next point I am taking here, multiplicative identity. See, one is the multiplicative identity for whole numbers. See, observe this problem. See, example I am making here, when we multiply any integers with 1, we are getting the same whole number. See here, 1 is the multiplicative identity for whole numbers. Observe this one example. When we multiply minus 3 into 1, again we are getting here minus 3. Again we are getting here minus 3. You take any number, minus 4 into 1, minus 4. Okay, you take any integer, when we multiply with 1, that is the 1 is the multiplicative identity. When we multiply integers by 1, we are getting same answer. That is the, we will call a into 1 equal 1 into a is equal to a. If you change the order of integers, you will get the same answer. This is what we call multiplicative identity. Next point, associativity for multiplication. See, the product of three integers does not depend upon the grouping of integers, and this is called the associative property for multiplication of integers. For any three integers, see here, for any three integers a comma b and c, that is a into b into c is equal to a into the bracket b into c. See, LHS and RHS both are equal. Okay, see one example here. I am making up one example. See, I am making up one example. Minus 3 into minus 2 into minus 5. Next, minus 3 into minus 2 into minus 5. See, I am taking here one example. See, when you multiply LHS and RHS by, see here, minus 3 into minus 2 into minus 5. See, when we multiply minus into minus, plus 3 into 2 is 6. Okay, 6 into minus 5. When we multiply again here, plus into minus, minus 6 into 5 is 13. Okay, this is the LHS side. If we again multiply in the RHS side also, see here, we are getting here minus 3 in the bracket, see, minus into minus plus 5 into 2 is 10. 10. See, when we multiply again here, see here, minus 3, see here, RHS side, minus 3 into, in the bracket, minus 2 into minus 5. When we multiply inside the bracket, see here, minus here, minus into minus, minus, minus into minus, plus 5 into 10. When we multiply again, see here, minus into plus, minus 3 into 10 is 30. See, when we multiply, we are getting the LHS and RHS side same answer. So, associative property, that is the for multiplication of integers. Okay, next I am going to take the next point.
Yes, friend, I am taking here next distributive property. As in, we know that the in the distributive property, LHS and RHS are both are equal. See, this is the 16 into in the bracket 10 plus 2 is equal to 16 into 10 plus 16 into 2. This is the RHS. This LHS and RHS both are equal. So we call distributivity of multiplication over addition. Dear friend, let us check if this is true for integers also. Now I am taking here one small example to check that this is a true for integers also. Okay, see one example. Okay, dear friend, I am taking here one example to check the distributivity of multiplication over addition. This is true for integers or not. See here, this is the LHS side, this is the RHS side. I will simplify the LHS side. See here, minus 4. See, when we simplify in the bracket, see, minus 2 plus 7 minus 4. See, this is the negative integer, this is the positive integer. So we want to here do subtraction. This is the big number, big integer. Big integer attached as a positive sign. So we have to take in the answer also positive sign. When we doing the subtraction, we are getting here 5. Okay, 5. Here positive sign. Because this big number attached with positive sign, so I put thing here the positive sign before the answer. So when we multiply, see, minus into plus, minus 4 into 5 is 20. This is the LHS side. This is the LHS. Now, we will solve here RHS side also. See here. Minus into minus plus 4 into 2 is 8. Okay. 4 into 2 is 8. Next, plus here also. Minus into plus minus 7 into 4 is 28. See, next, in the bracket, 8, plus into minus, minus 28. Now, we have one is the positive integer, one is the negative integer. Which is the big number here? 28 is the big number. 28 attached negative sign. So, we want to take here in the answer also negative sign. So, here, when we do the subtraction, 8 minus 28, we are getting here minus 20. So, this is the LHS, this is the RHS, both are equal. So, this distributive property for multiplication true for integers also. See, we can say that the distributivity of multiplication over addition is true for integers. Okay, in general, write this one, write down in general for any integers a and a comma b and c, a into in the bracket b plus c is equal a into b plus in the bracket a into c. Next, dear friend, I am going to solve next exercise.
Okay, dear friends, now I am taking here exercise 1.3. exercise first main. See here, first main, find each of the following products. See, dear friends, we have here total 10 problems. Here, I am solving here only 8 problems, remaining 2 problems in solve in 4. Okay, first one, see. See here, this is the positive integer 3 into minus 1. When we multiply, see here, plus into minus, minus 3 into 1, how much? 3. Answering 3. Okay. Next, second one problem. See here, we have here negative number, negative integer, minus 1. Here, positive. See, when we multiply minus into plus, we are getting here minus 225 into 1. Again, we are getting here 225. This is the solution. Okay, dear friend, next, third problem. See here, minus 21 into minus 30. This is the third problem. We have here two negative integers. If you have any confusion in sign multiplication, you write first sign. Okay, see here. I am writing here minus into minus number 8, 21 into 30. Okay, when we multiply negative sign, negative minus into minus, minus into minus, plus, see here, plus 21 into 30. How much here? 21 into 30? 21 into 30 here, 630. This is the answer. Okay, dear friend, next I am taking here fourth one problem. Here also we have two negative integers. Okay, first we have to do here multiplication of sign. Okay, we have to do here sign multiplication. Here also negative, here also negative. When we multiplying minus into minus, we are getting here plus. Okay, see here minus minus 316 into 1. Minus into minus, minus plus. Okay, 316 into 1. Again, we are getting here 316. This is the solution. Next, I am going to take here fifth on the problem. See, here we have 10. Another two integer is negative integers. Dear friend, as we discussed it, when you multiplying with 0, when we multiplying any integer with 0, again we get here 0. See here. See, this here we have zero. This is negative integer. This is also negative integer. See here solution. Minus 15 into 0 into minus 18. When we multiply with the 0, again we are getting here 0. If you multiply this one, again we get here 0. So 0 is answer. We know that if you multiply with 0, answer is always 0. Okay, that's it. I completed here 5th one. Next I am going to take here 6th one. See here, minus 12 into minus 11 into 10. See, I have taken here first negative integers. See here, solution. Minus 12 into minus 11 into 10. See, first you multiply sign. Okay, minus into minus, plus. 12 into 11. How much here? 132. Okay. Next, into 10. See here, when we multiply 132 into 10, we are getting here 1320. This is the solution. Okay, next one. See here, 7th one problem. G. See here, 9 into minus 3 into minus 6. Okay, we have here 2 negative integers, 1 is the positive integer. Yes, right? I am taking here 2 negative integers first. Okay, see here solution. 9 into minus 3 into minus 6. So I am taking the first negative integer. Into 9. Minus into minus. Plus 6 into 3 is the 18. Okay, see here minus into minus. Plus. Okay, minus into minus plus. So I am taking here negative integer first. Minus into minus plus 6 into 3 is how much? 18. Next remaining. When we multiply here 18 into 9, we are getting here 162. This is the solution. Okay. Yes, right. This is the last problem. See here. Minus 18 into minus 5 into minus 4. We have here 3 negative integers. Okay. If you multiply here odd numbers, again we getting here negative sign. If you multiply even number, you getting here positive integers. Okay. See here, we have here in this problem, we have odd number here. Okay. See here, first I am taking the solution. Minus 18 plus minus 5 into minus 4. Here, minus 18 into minus 5 into minus 4. See, when if you have confusion, you take first sign. Okay, I am taking your first sign. Minus into minus into minus into. In the bracket, 18 into 5 into 4. Okay, see, these are the odd numbers. Okay. Minus into minus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Again, we are getting here minus. Now, you multiply numbers here. 18 into 5 into 4. First, you multiply here. 5 into 4. See here. 18, first. See. 5 into 4, how much here? 20. When we multiply 18 into 20, we are getting here 100. We are getting here 18 into 20 is 360 minus 360. This is the answer. Dear student, you have in the exercise 1.3. First way, remaining 2 problems you solve in the homework. Okay, dear student, next I am taking here 2nd main in the exercise 1.3. See here, verify the following. See, we have here the problem. This is the LHS, this is the RHS. We have to find the LHS and RHS equal or not equal. Here, distribute property. Okay. See here, first one I am taking here LHS sign. See, LT, you want to remove here, bracket, first I am taking here in the bracket. See, 7 plus 3 to minus, minus 3. Okay. Again, 18. See here, 7 minus 3. When you doing the subtraction, you getting here. How much here? 4. Okay, 4. I am taking here positive sign. Because here, big number is 7. Big number 7 attached with the positive number sign. So I am taking in the answer also positive. Now 18 into 7. See, you multiply here 18 into 7. How much here? 72. Okay. 72. This is the L. Now I am taking here RHS sign. Now see here. 18 into 7. Again, in the bracket, 18 into minus 3. See here, first 18 into 7. How much here? 18 into 7, 126. Okay, 126. Now, here, one is the positive integer, another one is the negative integer. When we multiply positive into negative, we are getting here again negative. Okay, plus into minus, plus into minus, minus 18 into Riza, how much here? 54. Okay, next here 126 plus into minus, minus 54. Okay, next see here, when we doing the subtraction, 126 minus 54, we are getting again here 72. Okay, LHS and RHS both are equal. Okay, here's what. Next I am taking here. In this domain, you have another one problem. You solve that problem in O. Next I am taking here third domain. Okay, see here, first part of this third domain, for any integer A, what is minus 1 into A equal 2? Dear friend, when we multiply with minus 1, you might multiply any integer with 1. Again, you get in here same integers. Okay, see here. Answer is, when we multiply minus 1 into A, what is the answer here? Minus, again minus A. When we multiply minus 1 with any integer, again we get in here negative. See, this is the minus A is the answer. Next, I am going to here take second part of this question. Dear student, first we have to understand the question here. Determine the integer whose product with the minus 1 is. See, we have here some product. Okay, minus 22, 37 and 0. See, when we multiply with the minus 1, you take any integer. Okay, when you multiply with the minus 1, we want to sum is minus 22, 37 and 0. See, first one here, solution. We have here minus 1. Okay, minus 1. We want to multiply here one number. See, if I will take here, 22. Okay, I am taking here positive 22 plus 22 plus into minus, answer is minus 22 into 1, so how much? 22. See, this is the our answer. Good. Next time.
Good morning dear students. In this class I am solving here exercise 1.3 remaining problems. See, fourth one problem.
Starting from minus 1 into 5. Write various products showing some patterns to show minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 1. See, you want to write here some pattern to show minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 1. See, here already given, starting from minus 1 into 5. See here, minus 1 into 5 is equal to minus into plus, plus minus into plus is minus 5 into 1, 5. Okay, next, see here, next time, minus 1 into 4 minus into plus minus 4 into 1 minus 4. Now, see here, this one I am taking here, minus 5, if we add in plus 1, we are getting again minus 4. Okay, next pattern, minus 1 into 3 is equal, minus into plus minus 3 into 1 is 3. Okay, see here also I am taking here, minus 4 plus 1. If we add in here, minus 4 plus 1, again we are getting here, minus 3 is answer. Next pattern, see here, minus 1 into 2, minus into plus, minus 2 into 1, 2 is equal, see here, minus 3, I am adding here 1. See, when we add in minus plus 1 with minus 3, we are getting here again minus 2. Next, I am taking here next, minus 1 into minus 1. Okay, minus into plus, minus. Okay, answer is again 1. See here, if we add in minus 2 with plus 1, we are getting here minus 1. See here, next, minus 1 into 0. We know that when we multiply 0 with any integer, we are again getting here 0. Next here, see here, minus 1, I am multiplying here, plus with, I am adding here with plus 1. Again, we are getting here 0. Okay, next see here, minus 1 into minus 1. See here, minus into minus, plus 1 into 1, 1. Okay, 1 into 1, 1. See here, 0, when we are with 0, plus 1, again we are getting here 1. So, this is the pattern to show the minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 1. This is the answer. Dear student, next I am taking here fifth one problem. Dear student, I am taking here exercise 1.3, fifth one problem. See here, find the product using sugar properties. See, we have the question here, 26 into minus 48 plus minus 48 into minus 36. See here, we want to find out here product by using suitable property. See here, dear student, you observe here, minus 48, both sides we have, minus 48, minus 48. I am taking here minus 48 outside. See here, minus 48. Okay, next, remaining here, 26 plus minus 36. Minus 36. See, this is A, B plus C. So, this is the distributive property, distribution property. Okay, see here, A into B plus C, that should be A into B plus A into C. This is the distributive property. Okay, this is the distributive property. See here, I am simplifying here, minus 48, 26, plus into minus, minus 36. This is very easy to simplify. Okay, this is called minus 48. Here, 26 minus 36, remaining is minus 10. Okay, remaining is minus 10. Minus 10. Again, we multiply here. Minus into minus. Minus into minus, plus. Okay. Minus into minus, plus 48 into 10 is 480. This is the answer. 480 is the product. Okay. The property is distributive property. Yes, friend. I am taking. Yes, friend. See, I am taking the next problem. 8 into 53
minus 125. See, I am taking here 53 outside. See, this is the commutative property. See, commutative property means if you changing the order of integers, you getting the same number. So, commutative property is a into b into c is equal a into in the bracket b into c. This is the commutative property. See here. See, I am taking here 53 outside. To find out the answer very easily. So, I am taking here 53 outside and I will multiply plus 8 and 125. See here, 8 into minus 125. See, then we multiply 53 into, when we multiply plus into minus 125 into 8, 1000, total 1000. Next, we multiply here 53 into minus 1000. Plus into minus 53 into 1000, 53,000. This is the answer. Dear friend, next I am taking here third problem in fifth main. Okay, dear friend, I am taking here next third problem here. Now, 15 into minus 25 into minus 4 into minus 10. See, you observe this problem. See, I am solving this problem by taking commutative property. If you changing the order of integer, you getting the same answer. Now see here, solution 15 into minus 4 into minus 10. Okay, see here, 15. See, you multiply here, first one, minus into minus, plus 25 into 4 is 100. Okay, 25 into 4 is 100. Minus into minus, plus, okay, 100. Next, into minus 10. Again, you multiply here, 15 into, minus into, plus into minus, minus, 100 into 10, how much here? 1000. Okay. 1000. Again, you multiply here plus into minus minus 15 into 1000. 15,000. 15,000. Okay. This is the answer. Okay. This is the commutative. I am taking here next fourth problem. Minus 41 into 102. See here, 102. I am writing like this. See here. 102. I am writing 100 plus 2. If you add in these two numbers, again you get in here 102. See here, solution minus 41 into 100 plus 2. See, this is the distribution property. Distributive property. See here, a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. See here, we know that a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. This is the distributive property. So I am taking care of this problem. See here, a minus 41 into 100 next plus minus 41 into 2. When we simplify this one, we getting here minus 41 into 100. How much here? Total 4100. Minus into plus minus 4100. Okay. Next. See here. Next. Here. 41 into 2 is 41 into 2 is how much here? 82. Before that, we want to multiply the sign. Sign minus into plus minus 41 into 2 is 82. 82. Next. See here. Next. Minus 4100 plus into minus
minus 82. When we add 4100 and 82, because we have here both are negative side. When we add here, we are getting here 1182, and big sign is minus. Big number is 4100. So answer is minus 4182. This is the answer. Dear friend, next I am taking here fifth one problem. Okay, dear friend, in this exercise 1.3, fifth main, I am taking here only one question. Remaining questions you solve in home. See here, I am taking here next problem. 7 into 50 minus 2. Solution. See here. We know the distributive property. A into B plus C is equal A into B plus A into C. But here we have C, minus we have. So you change here this one, A into B minus A into C. This is distributive property. Okay, here minus we have. Okay, so see, I am writing here this one, this distributive property, A into B minus C is equal A into B minus A into C. This is the distributive property. See here. Next, I am taking here 7 into 50 minus 2. According to distributive property, 7 into 50 minus 7 into 2. See here. 7 into 5 is 35, here 0. Okay, 350. Next, minus 7 into 2 is 14. Okay, when you doing the 336, okay, this is the correct problem. This is the distribution property. Dear friend, you have remaining 3 questions in this main to solve those problems in 4. Next,